How can the delusional be allowed to diagnose the mental stability of other people? This question carries more weight than most people will ever acknowledge. My doctor recommended I see a psychiatrist so I could get a medical procedure I need, which they require seeing a psychiatrist for. This is nonsense, stupid, and insanity. Most of the United States is religious. In other words, most of the United States is delusional, and that includes most, if not all, psychiatrists. When I mention this fact, people get angry. Reality seems to anger a lot of people. Psychiatry on its own is really a misnomer. It should be called homeopathy junior, as it is attempting to define certain forms of thought as sane and others as not sane, when in reality they are simply alternative forms of thinking. I wager that there are a lot of psychopathic people in the world that are never diagnosed as such. The only time they ever find these people is when they actually harm someone. But a psychopathic person, like delusional people, can live among society without problem more often than not. This is only one of many examples, and anything that actually is a detriment to the person can be diagnosed better by a general medical practitioner. However, since most psychiatrists are delusional, then why are they the ones allowed to control the lives of other people? When I was a child, I had an imaginary friend. I never named him, but he was always there. I grew out of him when I became an adult. But because I would not call my imaginary friend the name of the god that my mother called hers, I was diagnosed as schizophrenic as a child by the very people who purported to talk to and hear their imaginary friends. They just call theirs God. The part of this that makes the psychiatrist even more insane is that they are grown adults who should have grown out of such silly things. I was then put on experimental medication, in other words, untested medication, for what they diagnosed. I cannot even recall the name of it anymore. However, I do recall a lawsuit about it a decade or more ago that I had not learned of until it was old news. They had found it caused permanent depression in those that were given it, and has long since been removed from the market. So my response to my doctor was that unless she wanted to see me in prison for murder, she would not recommend that again. Many will gasp and think that it is an idle threat, yet it is not. I am able to live in society without being in danger to it, so long as I am not forcibly in front of a psychiatrist. I'm currently at a very low point in my depression, an almost irresistible urge to kill either myself or find one of those I hate enough to kill. Suicide by cop is the label this plan often gets. I'm literally the type of person that if I did go off the deep end, everyone who knows me would be shocked and surprised. Well, except those who know me on forums. Society is a utility to me. At least the United States society is. Back to the topic. People of the world, realize that you are allowing the delusional psychiatrists who lack the ability to diagnose anything that is not easily discerned or admitted to, who cannot even see that they are delusional, the right and power to diagnose you and your children. The psychiatrist is even more insidious, actually, as they are permitted to not only control your lives, but also destroy them without any form of recourse. By allowing psychiatrists to rule you, you are allowing the insane the power to declare you insane for any reason at any time. My gripe in all this, as I truly would be unable to care less if not for this fact, is that they have control of my life because of a medical procedure I need to survive. The longer it is delayed, the more my health degrades, and the more I want to destroy the entire medical industry in some way. This is what is causing my low points currently, and in order for me to stop these low points from becoming dangerous, I need my health back, for I will not die alone unless I can be happy with my life. This is a big thing to admit, especially in video online. But there you have it. I am a danger not only to myself, but also to any psychiatrist so long as I do not have the procedure completed. I do not make threats. I only warn people what I am capable of. I cannot lie about anything. I make this video now as I am close to rock bottom, too close to the edge, and no one who could do anything about it is caring. To those who do care, though, thank you. But emotional support is useless to me. Also, the procedure is not a cosmetic one. I do not trust cosmetic doctors anyways.